I'd like to get a sprinter like that one day. Put ESNews on it. Is it Munguia's Ferrari?
No, hell no.
That's a cool car. He has his own sprinter. That's cool. It's a nice car. Oh, here's Jaime. We're gonna get him going into the sprinter. The fans rushing. Thank you, Jaime.
Gracias, Jaime. Nos vemos mañana. La brindada. La brindada, champ.
Eric, you like the car?
Yes, it's nice.
Nice. Oh, sorry. You good, you good, you good.
El champ andaba firmando ahí con esos.
You got it. Check it out. Team Munguia, their own sprinter. Eric likes it. I should get an ESNews printer. Have a moving podcast. What do you think, guys? Moving podcast, ESNews printer. How you guys doing? Reporting. So Munguia left the gym with Eric. A lot of interviews coming up. But how's it going? See you guys. Have a good one. A lot of fans are happy. We're here in Santa Ana. City pool over here. Welcome, TKO Boxing. Hello, hello.
Hi.
Hi. This is the home of Ronnie Rios and of Alexis Rocha. How'd it go today? Did it go well? Everything?
Yeah, it was crowded.
Hey, some dude had his Ferrari out there. I go, oh, is this Munguia's car? He got a little offended. He goes, it's SOS Boxing. I thought it was Munguia's car. He came in a sprinter. I want to get a sprinter. I got ESNews on it.
Yeah.
Let me build a studio inside. It'll be a moving podcast. How'd it go today, though?
Good.
Yeah, Munguia's popular. He's been popular since he was 22.
Yeah,
we want to see him fight Charlo. We want to see him fight Canelo. We want to see him fight
big fight.
Triple G. Right. And I hope he gets it. That's what boxing is all about. Like, I respect Ryan Garcia for wanting to fight Tank. You want to fight the best.
Exactly.
What's the point of doing this if you're not going to fight? Ronnie Rios about to fight MJ was two championship belts in his division. What's next for Alexis Rocha? July 16, Staples Center. Okay, stay tuned. But he's very popular and he sells. That's the man of the house. This is, we're live. I said we're
top
live.
10, pound for pound.
Okay, go ahead.
I know people are going to give me shit for this, but I'm going to say it anyway.
This is Coach Hector, by the way. He was in Brooklyn for Tank's fight, by the way.
Because I think Canelo, the things he's done to go up in so many weight classes is insane. It's hard enough to win a title in one weight class. That's why I still give him.
Same here. Okay, Canelo, he's still undisputed, 68.
Yes.
Okay.
Crawford, number two. You don't like that?
Monster. No, I have Spence at number two, but Crawford three. Same, you know, okay.
Monster,
okay,
three.
Inoue, three. He just beat Donaire.
Fury's got to be up there.
He's retired. You
okay.
Retired,
well,
fired.
He says fighters never retire. It's a matter of how much money and he'll come out. You know that.
Okay.
I would definitely have probably Spence in there.
Okay. I think you're a five right now, right?
Yeah. Shakur.
That's six.
tough one the last few.
Easy. Benavides. Tank, I like the way you're going with that. Usyk.
Usyk, I forgot about Usyk.
You still have Loma.
I think Usyk's going to lose, though, against Joshua this time. I think if Robert, he's got somebody in the corner who knows what the hell they're doing. I think Robert's going to make enough tweaks here and there that I think Joshua's going to pull.
He's going to bring the beast out of him.
I think so, too. He's going to get him a little bit more aggressive.
And all respect to Usyk, because I like him as a person, but it's boxing, and we'll see what happens.
I think you got to use, I think Joshua's size to his advantage.
Pound for pound, Jermell Charlo.
Oh, yeah, Charlo.
He looked great with, and no one gave him a shot. Before he fought Castaño, everybody told me, everyone on camera picked Castaño.
I didn't. I said Charlo.
But you always,
you asked me.
I know, but you always pick against what everybody else picks.
No, that's not true. I just try to make, Charlo's unbelievable. But, I mean, I don't know. Like you said, okay, where do you put Munguia? Where do you put Zurdo?
They're great fighters.
You're talking about undefeated fighters.
I want to see them fight the best. I want to see Bivol and Zurdo, or Zurdo and Bitterbath Joe Smith winner.
I think it's going to be Bivol and Zurdo. I think that's a great
fight. Who wins?
That's a tough fight. Right now, it looks like Bivol looks like they're beating, but I'm, like I said, I told you guys, there's something about Zurdo. He throws a lot of punches. He's very long. He's tall, so I don't know. It's going to be a 50-50 fight, for sure.
I would say this. Munguia got on the scene, made a big splash at 22 years old.
Yes.
Everyone loved him, everything.
Yes.
He's been winning.
Fan-friendly.
He's exciting.
Name in front of him. That's the problem.
He won. I talked to him today. He said, Elie, I would love to fight Charlo. Both of them. I would love to fight Triple G. Well, Triple G after Canelo, I think, is done.
He should be done. Yeah.
And you still have Boo Boo out there?
There's a lot of good fights. If you're a fight fan, some great fights coming up. How can you
not be excited? I'm not excited about the Haney rematch. I know he's going to win the rematch. I don't see Kambosos doing anything different.
I don't like that fight at all.
But they have to do it because you have to respect your contracts. And you.
It's boxing. Who the hell gives a shit about a contract? You know that they change it. We've been the number one contender, the mandatory for MJ for 2 years. So the hell.
Ronnie, come here really quick.
It's all bullshit anyway.
Ronnie's fighting June 25th. You're out, Alexis?
Yeah, I'm gonna come back.
Was that your Ferrari out front? I thought it was Munguia's.
No, he has a Corvette.
What year?
Brand new, just bought it.
You got a Corvette?
Yeah.
Hey, drive carefully. That goes from 0 to 60 in 2. Yeah. Don't speed.
Don't be like Chris Spence.
Don't speed.
Okay, would you like to see Tim Davis fight us?
Ryan Garcia in December. I'd like to see him fight Loma. I like to. Yeah, it's an okay fight too, but
He's got all the belts.
The belts don't matter. Who's friend? You ask me what's fan friendly. You can have all the belts, but you can't sell an arena. Your fans don't resonate with you. It's hard.
Probably.
You want to?
It's a little bit boring. I know what people are saying, but it's smart. I mean, it's hit and not get hit. Haney, he beat him with his jab.
He did. He won, and he went, and he had injuries that nobody knows about. He had 3 different injuries that he pulled it off.
Fighters are never 100%.
No, but I'm right. But I'm saying people don't even know with that performance, and he still did it. Kambosos was a letdown. I expected more.
Yeah. It just looked like he had no game plan. He went in and he thought, I'm going
to
hit
him. The footwork, he was tripping over himself. And he
didn't look bad. Can't hit what's not in front of you. Yeah, exactly. He was frustrated.
We love boxing, but we love knockouts.
Yes.
Tim Bradley saying on the broadcast, Haney's destroying Kambosos. Can you destroy someone without hurting them?
It's, I don't know. Depends.
Yeah, but
you can ask 100 people, you're going to get 100 different.
That's true. I agree. Everybody likes something different. Like, Alexis Rocha, probably Ronnie Rios, are boxing connoisseurs.
Yes.
They appreciate Haney's style very much.
Yes.
But a lot of fans would love to see Ryan Garcia's style, a tank style, where it's exciting.
Well, they want to see knockouts, and that's the bottom line. You want to see two guys go at it. They want to see somebody on the floor.
And if you're not getting the knockouts, you have to have that personality like a Floyd that could sell.
Absolutely.
It's hard. But
that's what makes it pound for pound, the ability to sell.
That's what Spence told me. That's why Spence has Canelo number one.
And I know people gave me shit because of Canelo, but what he's done, I mean, how many guys you see him doing that?
He's making more per fight than a million people make a lifetime.
Got, Elie, but look at all the weight classes he's gone up and he's beaten.
47, 54, 60, 68, 75.
That's great.
Yeah. But you know what? I'm going to tell you something about Canelo, and you're a coach, so maybe you can answer this. Canelo loves boxing.
Yes.
He loves the gym. He loves training. He likes everything about the sport. Not every fighter that I interview loves the sport. Some do it because it's the money, because what they're doing, they're already too deep in to quit. Do your fighters love boxing? Do they love everything about the gym?
They love coming in here. It's not like we're making 30, 40, 50 million like they are.
55.
Right. 55.
Ronnie, How much do you love boxing? But not everybody's like that.
I think you get burned out. You need to
take a break, charge it.
Sometimes you need to take a break.
But you know what's amazing about a story like Canelo or even Rowley or a lot of fighters, they come into a sport and they start from humble beginnings with zero and they become household names and they make millions of dollars. Tank, Ryan from Victorville. If you're very wealthy, you don't get into boxing. No one's going to start
rich.
I think
it's going to be hard to get up every morning and get up at 4 or 5 in the morning and run and go to the gym for 2 or 3 hours, do your strength and conditioning. It's going to be harder when you're sitting so cheap.
Well, it's harder with this generation. It's hard to do even when they don't have shit. Am I right? The kids, when they come to the gym, they're different. So how do you keep the gym so clean? What's the secret?
Right here.
Every day?
Every day.
That's the way it is.
He runs the gym.
Great job. The gym looks amazing because I've been to some gyms where you're worried.
So you're going to catch a disease and stuff, yeah. Well, you can probably catch something here, but Drew does a good job.
That's good. How many kids train here?
Well, around with the pros and amateurs, we have about a good, 10 to 12, but then around 5:30, we have about 60 to 80 kids every night.
Is it free for the kids in Santa Ana?
All free.
So if I'm in Santa Ana, and we're live, and I'm watching this video, how did they get a hold of you guys? How did they come here to sign up?
I'm going to go look up Jerome Center or TKO Boxing.
TKO Boxing, and you want to learn how to box, you want to be the next Ronnie Rios, the next Alexis Rocha, coming to gym?
Absolutely.
What age is the minimum?
Start them as 8, as early as 8.
8 years old, and what's the oldest age they could come?
I probably wouldn't take anybody over 20. We had to come back
to all right, 8 to 20 if you're in Santa Ana. You have to be a Santa Ana resident, right?
Not really.
No? All right. Is there anybody around the world watching this? You want to come train with Coach Hector? Come to the gym. Thank you, guys. Stay tuned right here. Always reporting. Hey, Hector, do you have a key to the basketball court?
Open. You want to shoot some baskets?
Yeah, let's see. Wow. Let's see. Who wants that smoke?
Let's go.
You know what? Hector has a J.
Let's go. Let's go. Oh, well, watch out now.
Hey,
did you get bumped up by Ryan? I did. But still, that one L does not stop me.
Hey, Ryan.
Look at that. Look at that. Guys, you want to see some basketball here in Santa Ana? Check it out. It's a nice gym. With jeans. Yeah. Well, no, that's, I guess we'll have to, hey, coach, let's go with Ed. They're not gonna pass you the ball, these kids. Ed got skills, look at that. You played in college?
No.
High school? Where World High School?
Jersey.
Hey, did you play in high school?
No.
College?
No.
Okay. All right, shoot again. I need to see who you shoot like. That's a ringer. You know who's the best pro boxer basketball player? Adrian Broner. He's a very athletic.
Better than Roy Jones?
Yeah, way better.
Way better.
Way better. Adrian can play. Come on, you gotta make at least a couple. No, I'm shooting right now. In a second. All right, I got that, but we're live. Do it again. Hold on.
Hector can shoot, though. He can shoot.
Everybody in Santa Ana can shoot. You're like Steph Curry in game one.
It's the pressure.
Nah, there's no pressure. There's no pressure. You block everything out. There you go. Oh. He just needs to get his rhythm. If I turn off the live.
Yeah, I got that. Is basketball popular here? So it's all boxing.
It's all boxing. Come around and have some fun with the kids.
That's awesome to have a basketball court next door.
It's fun.
But it's not gonna help you in a street fight. Oh, look at that. 2 out of 3. They did say you could shoot. Look at that. What do you guys think, Coach Hector? I was just gonna say, that was good stuff though. That was good, we got it, we're live. I'll tell you, here, hold it, let it is.
All right, Elie Seckbach right here with the jumper. There you go. They're saying quit. They said air ball.
They were right on that
Yeah. You gotta jump higher. Elie Seckbach, reporting, show them what you got. Got an external charger. There you go. Oh. Nice, one. I can edit it and make it like it went in. But yeah, Santa Ana, Randy Rios from this gym is fighting June 25th for two belts at the 122 division. He's ranked number one in the world. And Alexis Rocha, who last beat Blair Cobbs, is gonna fight on Ryan Garcia card. All right, represent Santa Ana. Basketball is a very fun game. You know why it's good for boxers? Because if you just run, it gets boring and you get a rhythm. But basketball is explosive energy, like in the ring. All the boxers love basketball. Shane, Pacquiao, Chris Areola, Mayweather, Errol Spence and Crawford want to play one-on-one. Maybe that should be the lead into their fight. The fans are the winners, but it's hard for me to see anyone beat Errol Spence. All right, guys, we're going to have lots of videos for you today. Stay tuned. Footwork of basketball and boxing with the pivot. Look at the video I did with Mayweather when Devin Haney was 16. Mayweather talks about pivoting in boxing. A lot of good boxing coaches tell me, use the pivot from basketball in boxing. If you wanted to knock down the ball, you couldn't do it. 3, 2, 1, game. I think there was only one Mexican in the NBA, right? He played for Dallas. There was a Mexican dude in the NBA. Tanahara, what was his name? Who remembers the dude from Mexico in the NBA?
He played for Dallas.
Yeah.
Didn't he play for Denver?
He did. What was his name? Yeah, Nahara. There was a Puerto Rican kid that was like 5'5", 5'6". Good dude.
JJ
Barrera, huge boxing fan.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he was like 5'6", killing it, putting Puerto Rico on the map. There you go. I think we should end it with that. Stay tuned. Oh, soccer, that's the sport here. That's the sport in Santa Ana. Very popular. What's your favorite team in Mexico?
Mexico? They're not in the first division anymore, but it's Morelia.
All right.
Morelia.
That's your team.
Yeah.
Hopefully they get back.
Yeah.
All right, guys. So there you have it. Another day at the gym. Thanks so much for that. I'll be back to play basketball. Give me a few weeks. You said he can't play, huh? He got all that smoke. How's it going? What's your name? What is it? What's your record, Abel?
My record is 36-4.
That's badass. Keep it going. When are you going to turn pro?
Hopefully soon. I'm fighting in the U.S. men's.
115, 120? What are you?
125.
125, all right.
Yeah.
Anybody you want to call out from the pros right now? Put them on notice?
No, just everybody has to stay.
Anybody can't get it, huh?
Anybody.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. Tell everybody your name.
Julian Bravo.
Julian, what's your record?
I recently had an ad fought a couple of years. I was 3-3.
That's okay.
My last fight was in ringside in Missouri. Right.
Keep going. Don't take a break. Try not to if you can.
Yes, sir.
And hopefully you can turn pro and make some money.
Yep.
Win some titles.
That's the goal.
One-on-one in a basketball court. Who wins?
You. Rob don't want the smoke.
Yeah, JJ for sure.
Hey, who's the best 135 pounder in the world?
Best 135?
Right now, I think
Gervonta.
Gervonta?
Yeah.
I think he's good. I think he's
good. Gervonta is great.
He has a lot of power, but he can work on his skill by just a little bit more.
Yeah.
He gets
caught a lot.
He's never been dropped in his life.
Yeah, he's been
maybe he lets them hit him. Maybe he lures them in.
Yeah.
He told me before the Leo fight, I'm going to let Leo hit the night before. I said, I'm going to let Leo hit me just to see how hard he hits, to let him think that I can't fight. And how did that end? How do you do with Barrios? How do you do with every 25 or 27 opponents? People love knockouts. People love excitement. I agree. All right, guys, have a good one. Stay tuned. Thank you so much. Beautiful gym. I'll be back. It just, I need to get before the traffic. Yeah, I'm going to play basketball next time. Anybody can get it. Thank you. I'll be back. All right, guys, I'm going to stay live. This is Ed. He does all the public relations for all the fighters, all the promoters. He's in the Hall of Fame. Boxing Writers honored.
Build it from there.
See you guys. Have a good one. Thank you so much. Nice being here. Amazing. I'll be back.
What did the people say? Could I shoot or not?
We're live. I have to go back and look what they said. But hey, Ronnie, you against your coach in basketball. Who wins?
Come on.
Yeah, I suck at basketball.
None of those guys can beat me.
At least admit it.
And you.
Basketball.
Nobody here can beat me.
Best one is Lex.
Oh,
Lex,
God,
Lex can make it rain.
Hey.
Lex can make it rain.
What's his name? Senor, do you play basketball?
Play a basket?
No.
Puro fútbol, ¿le da ya? Puro
fútbol,
dígale. Puro boxeo.
Puro boxeo.
Who's the best boxer in the world right now?
¿Quién es el mejor boxeador del mundo?
Del mundo.
Ahorita, en este momento.
Vivol.
He's up to speed.
Damn. Ouch.
What happens in a rematch?
La revancha.
La revancha.
¿Quién gana? Lo mismo. Sí. I think it's killing me hard to beat
people.
I'll take
Wayne.
Yeah, but he's gonna beat Triple G. That's cool.
And then they're gonna go.
Hey, señor, ¿cómo se llamas? Ruben, who's the best fighter in the history of boxing? In the history? Chavez?
Sanchez or Chavez?
Roberto Duran?
Roberto Duran?
LOL.
That's funny.
He is
going to
have to disagree,
but I think that explains the people that I would throw his name on.
That's fair.
Malik Scott always tells me he's the greatest heavyweight ever. And Malik sparred him, he sparred Usyk, he sparred
Klitschko. Best 135 pounder right now.
Gervonta Davis, who beats Gervonta? Okay, so
the top guys.
25 people out of 27. That's a great fight. Him and Ryan is an explosive fight.
That'll
be a great fight. You got Ryan? Who do you got? Tank or Ryan?
Man, I'm gonna have to go with.
But Teofimo's at 140 now. But it just shows that Teofimo was sick and injured when he fought Kambosos. Because Kambosos didn't improve overnight from...
No.
You know what I was missing, Coach? You're a coach. How do you get the most out of your guy? How do you light a match under their ass when they're not...
I mean, so many different personalities. Some you can yell and
they'll wake up.
Others you can't. It depends on the fighter.
What does it take to wake a fighter up, to snap out of what he's going through? Go back to round one and reset? Because okay, look, Kambosos was there, 37,000 fans, and by round four, it was quiet, like the place was in COVID empty building. You gotta do something.
It goes back to boxing. Styles make fights. Like, he got outboxed by Haney.
He did. Haney did his job.
He's probably more comfortable going back against freaking Teofimo, so styles make fights.
Yeah, but it's crazy. That's boxing. We never know who's gonna win. On paper, people win, but you win in the ring.
It wasn't fan friendly, like I said earlier.
It's not going to be fight of the year.
No.
It's not going to get. It's not going to get round of the year, knockout of the year, event of the year.
No.
But it's about W's, and he got the W.
Boring fight of the year. I mean, maybe. I can see why people would say that. But.
What were you going to say, Ronnie?
No, I was just going to say, Styles made fights. Perfect example of that. I always think of as Muhammad Ali when he fought Ken Norton.
That's it.
He would always struggle with Ken Norton, but he would always beat Joe Frazier. Right?
I think that was Randy Alexis.
I think
that's her, yeah.
Cool. What is
it? Bada. Oh. Testing time.
You know what's crazy? They don't like me. They see me, they'll say, turn off your camera.
Really?
Yeah.
Here right now.
They're going to freak out when they see me.
Yeah. I told you not to post that picture of you flexing.
No, this is my thing. Okay. My thing with VADA, I'm going to explain to you guys what's my beef. They say it's non-profit, voluntary. They charge $30,000 from each fight. Now, a pregnancy test costs $12. A COVID test costs $20 or up to $150. You've been around for 8 years doing the same fucking test. It shouldn't be costing $30,000 when you have everything in place. And if anything...
And you're non-profit.
Where's all the money going to? They made millions and millions and millions. I don't know. It's possible. But I'm saying, you know, that's what bothers me. Like, if you did it for the love... Not for profit. Charge fighters $10, $100, $200. Just to, and test everybody. Don't just test the guys fighting for the titles, because someone working away from the title could be all dirty.
I mean, it's not a level playing field.
Only do it, yeah.
I mean, they only test the guys they want to, or if it's a big title shot. Which is,
that's true.
The guys that are not juicing the 8-10 rounders.
Yeah, that's true. But not only that, but here's what I'm saying. How do we know when they say they test two guys that they're really testing? There's no evidence, there's no proof, there's no track record. They could say. No, you're just evidence. But I'm saying they could pick and choose who they want to test. When I was with Charlo in camp for Castaño, they tested him every other day. They tested him after the fight, before the fight. Who tests a guy the day of
the contract? They requested body test?
Yeah, but I don't know. But I'm saying after the weigh-in, when he's drained and hungry, you're testing him in the back. Why would you do that? And I don't know if they tested the other side. I hope they did, but I don't know.
They're supposed to. On our contract, the days he gets tested, MJ gets tested.
Okay.
So we're pretty much on equal...
Even playing field. Well, that's good. But I just want to see the cost be affordable for every fighter. That's all.
Yeah, that $30,000 makes absolutely no sense.
I should open up my own ES News testing and charge people. Just kill the market. Be like a Costco of testing.
I'll work for you.
Call yourself a nonprofit.
Yeah. That's it. So I could keep up to 98% in California. If it's a nonprofit in California and someone donates you $100, you could keep up to 98% and you're still legal.
We're nonprofit for our gym.
84% if you keep is considered 5-star rating. One time this orphanage called me. They wanted my help with something with celebrities and stars. So I meet the guy and he tells me, come in my hotel. He was staying at the Waldorf Astoria in Beverly Hills with $1,700 a night. It killed my old motivation because I'm volunteering. At least don't tell me, let's meet at Starbucks. That was nonprofit. Not saying that everybody's crooked or not crooked. I'm just saying some people abuse it.
That's tough. That's
yeah.
A tough one.
But yeah, I would like. Guys, we're live. You get to see this. I'm gonna hide in the back. They won't see me. They don't yell at me. I know. So Ronnie Rios doing VADA testing right here in the gym. They don't know I'm recording.
No.
We're live. What did you think of Jaime Munguia today?
So in my head.
Three rounds? Okay.
But I did not. My coach is really hard. It was good. It was kind of a short workout, but he looked very slick and mobile.
Good thing. Okay, guys, I'm going to stop the live. I'm going to go to record on the camera. Stay tuned. EsNews Boxing.com, Elie Seckbach reporting.